day, and I was pretty startled because I'd worked out there several years and never seen anything like this, never heard of anything like this. And I said, "Is this a UFO?" And he's smiling at me and he says, "I can't tell you that. I can't tell you that." What I knew he meant was it was, but he couldn't tell me. So I said, "What are you going to do with this information?" And he said, "Well, we always have to airbrush them out before we sell them to the public."
I was asked to go over to this facility on Langley Air Force Base where the NSA was bringing in the information from the lunar orbiter. And so I packed up some tools. I went over. I went into the facility. A couple of officers took me into this hangar. It was a very large hangar. So they took me into this laboratory. I took a look at the equipment. There was an airman second class in there. I was an airman second class as well. At the time, I didn't know what the real purpose of this dark room and this operation and this facility was. I thought this was where they were bringing the data in and then releasing the images to the public. They were doing 35 millimeter strips of film at that time, which were then assembled into 18 and a half by 11 inch mosaics, they were called. There was a digital signature and a grayscale on every 35 millimeter strip. And those strips were from successive passes around the moon. So he was showing me how all this worked, and we walked over to one side of the lab, and he said, "By the way, we've discovered a base on the back side of the moon." And at that point, I became frightened, and I was a little terrified, thinking to myself that if anybody walks in the room now, I know we're in jeopardy, we're in trouble, because he shouldn't be giving me this information. And then he pulled out one of these mosaics and showed this base, which had geometric shapes. There were towers, there were spherical buildings, there were very tall towers, and things that looked somewhat like radar dishes, but they were large structures. If I compare it to what I've seen now, because I do have photographs that have artifacts in them that are similar to what I saw, they're massive. Some of the structures are, you know, a half a mile in size. So they're huge structures. Some of the buildings seem to have very reflective surfaces on them. A couple of structures that I saw reminded me of cooling towers at power generating plants. They had that sort of a shape. Some of them were just very, very straight and tall with a flat top. Some of them were round. Some of them looked like a Quonset hut, you know, with a domed kind of like a greenhouse. The particular shot that I saw, there were several clustered together over a landscape, a fairly large landscape. I didn't want to look at it any longer than that because I felt that my life was in jeopardy. And I knew that the young fellow who was sharing this was really, really overstepping his bounds at that point. I worked there for three more days, and I remember going home and naively thinking, "I can't wait to hear about this on the evening news." And here it is, more than 30 years later, and